In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to use SunFounder's ESP32 microcontroller to play musical note with this buzzer and the transistor. Let's get started with this, and if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now. Thank you. ESP32 starter kit from SunFounder. This is the best ESP32 learning kit from SunFounder. It has this ESP32 microcontroller, which has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. This board can do everything Arduino Uno can do or many other Arduinos can do, plus extra more features. Because we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, the possibilities are endless. You can get connected to the cloud or do the control or read information or values via your mobile device or your desktop or over the cloud from a far location. It comes with a camera extension kit where you can stream the video over Wi-Fi either through the cloud or to your network, and also it comes with micro SD card where you can save images on the micro SD card, or you can write from the device any information, log the information on the device and read it back. You can power the board using this included 18650 lithium battery, and it has built-in charger where you can connect micro USB and charge the battery. The kit comes with 320 pieces of component that you can learn tons of projects. The left side, click on 3.2 custom tone. This is our project. Last time we used active buzzer, but this time we are using passive buzzer, which uses electromagnetic and it has just winding, and we can play some kind of music, for example do, re, ma, fa, sol, lo, ti, if I've read it properly. We need these components like before: ESP32 module, extension camera module, camera extension module, breadboard, wires, 1 kilo ohm resistor, our passive buzzer, and the transistor S8050, and we can use any of these pins. And this is a schematic. This is our buzzer. It has a positive negative terminal. The positive is connected to 3.3 volts. The negative is connected to this NPN transistor, where the transistor has three pins. Collector is connected to the negative, and emitter, this arrow is emitter, it is connected to the ground. And this pin is called base. It's connected via a 1 kilo ohm resistor to pin 14. This transistor acts as a switch. When we receive high signal or 3.3 volts, the resistor is protecting this transistor. This is a current limiting. So this will turn on this transistor as a switch. So this is completely become a switch, and the negative will be connected to ground. And as a result, the positive is already connected. When the negative is connected to the ground, it sounds, it buzzes. And we are using the one that has a PCB soldering in it. This one. And here is a wiring diagram, the same as before. And we have code, which I'm going to explain it fully. And there is some explanation for the code as well. For this lesson, we need this passive buzzer. The long pin is positive, and the positive also has label here. The one that has no PCB, as I mentioned, we need 1 kilo ohm resistor. And we need some wires on our breadboard. And our ESP32 and a camera extension board. You could use it without this extension, but this will make it very easy. Let's use this. So first, let's enter our buzzer. This pin is long, the positive on this side. Let's insert it somewhere on the breadboard, like this. And let's connect our transistor. This side is collector. So get the flat side towards you and just insert it. Spread the pins a little so it can be inserted somewhere like this. Connecting positive to the right pin. And let's connect the negative to the left pin. There are two pins empty in between. Now let's get our transistor. And this side is flat. Insert it somewhere in three rows side by side, like this. And then this left pin will be connected to the right pin, which is collector, to the collector of the transistor. Get 1 kilo ohm resistor, bend it, and from the middle wire, which is base, insert it to the middle wire and insert it somewhere on the left side, like that. Get a blue wire and connect it to the line where the resistor is connected. Then get a black wire and it will be connected to the emitter, which is the last pin on the left side. Now we have three wires ready. And here our positive will be connected to 3.3 volts. Because the buzzer that I've shown you is 5 volts, you can connect it to 5 volts and 3.3 volts, but I'm connecting it to 3.3 volts as shown here. This is ground. Ground is connected to the second pin, which is ground here. And blue is connected to pin 14. And that is pin 14. Just leave three holes. And now let's see how we can select the ESP32 board. We can click here under the select board and type here ESP32DEV. As soon as you type dev, you will see dev board. You can select it and click OK. So the board has been selected. Now we have to select the port. The other way to select the board is click on Tools, Board, ESP32, and select the ESP32 dev module. Now we have to select the port. If I click here, it shows two ports and I don't know which one belongs to my device. Sometimes you will not see the number properly. So the best way to be sure, right click on the start menu, go to the device manager, and you will see here the ports. If I click on this arrow, it will show me the ports. One is USB serial CH340, the other is USB serial device. And here, now it's connected. If I disconnect this, one of them disappear. The one that disappeared is my board. So 6 stays and 8 disappeared. If I connect it, so 8 is my COM port, CH340. Now 8 is my COM port and I can select it. Or I can click on Tool, Port, and here you will see it. You can select whichever you want. Ours is COM8. Now we have successfully selected the board and the port. And this is very important. It must be done first. Now let's open our code. Click on File, Open. On the left side, click on Downloads. Double click on ESP32 Starter Kit Main. Double click on C. Double click on Codes. Custom Tone, double click, and then Custom Tone, and then 3.3 Custom Tone File, click and open it. Difference with the previous lesson is that we have defined a pen, buzzer pen integer constant, and then we have set the resolution for the pulse width modulation signal, 8-bit, and then we are creating these frequencies. This is an array. We have explained about array in previous lessons. This is variable with multiple values of type integer. So these are our frequencies for some kind of musical note. And this is a function that when you call play frequency, it will run, and it has two parameter, frequency and duration, and it will get the frequency using LEDC write tone, and it goes to channel zero with the frequency, and then it sends the duration delay, which comes from here, and then sets it back to zero. LEDC write tone, which was set here, and we are setting it back to zero to stop. Now inside the setup, we are defining LED setup channel zero with 2000, with a frequency of 2000, with a resolution of 8-bit. Here, because we have defined 8 at the top, and then LEDC attach pin, we are defining buzzer pin to pin 0, which is the channel 0 of pulse width modulation, and inside the loop, which runs from here to here. By the way, this code will run only once, and this code will run continuously because this is a loop. And inside this loop, we have our own for loop, which goes from 0 to less than 7, which is 6. So from 0 to 6, and with I changes, this I becomes 1, 2, 3, up to 6. When it becomes 7, it will exit. Now, when the I changes, I is 0, it goes to frequency, and it gets the element 0. This is 0, this is 1, 2, 3, and so forth. So we are getting it, and we are playing the frequency. So this is sending the frequency, and this is sending the duration, 300 milliseconds. And then we wait 50 milliseconds after it's turned off, and it comes back, it sends the next frequency, which picks up from this list, and as a result, we should hear some kind of sound or musical note. And then after that, we have 1 second delay after all the tones are played, and it comes back and repeats this all over again. Now I'm just clicking to upload the code. Now the code is being uploaded, and I've not connected it. I'm waiting for this to finish the upload. Now the code is finished and I'm connecting it. So if you are the music guy, you can write your own music and play with it. Have fun. And how about this one? And here is a built-in example from Arduino. Click on File, Examples. Go to Digital, and then we have here Tone Keyboard, Tone Melody, Tone Multiple. And if I click on Melody, this is the code. The only thing that I changed was this. I made it 14, it was 8, and I made this one also 14, and just upload the code. And here, let's see. That's it. So this was just once. If you want to run this continuously, we have to get this portion from for loop, from for up to here. Loop and place it inside the loop and then give some kind of delay. 1000 for first, after 1 second it will repeat again, and let's upload the code. And let's see the result now.